Sarah, what do you think? We know, of course, the rate decision is looming. Now, many economists have said that rates are likely to rise. If it doesn't, is this the cue for Albo to go, all right, let's get one in the bag as soon as possible?
Look, I just don't think so. I think what will hold up his decision to call the election is the fact that, you know, the US is going to an election shortly, as in November. So that's getting a lot of airtime at the moment in the media. So I don't think he's going to want that to basically distract his campaign. We've also got the Queensland election that will be happening as well. And I think Labor are probably likely to think they're going to win that as well. So even though, we might have an announcement to say interest rates will be rising at some stage, whether or not the banks pass that on and whether or not people will actually feel that impact before he calls an election, I just don't see that happening. And so I think he's going to call it next year.
I think Sarah makes some really good points there. There's just not much clear air to have an election this year. November, no. US election, October, Queensland, and of course, September is football finals. Let me ask you, Rachel, the cabinet reshuffle, do you think that that changed people's perceptions of the competency of the government and their ability to govern going forward?
Look, not at all. You know, he would be mad to go early until he gets inflation under control, until the interest rates drop. I think he'll go a full term, if not close to. And I don't think the reshuffle is going to help in this instance.
Yeah, no, it's funny you mentioned the inflation numbers because, of course, they were released this week and you've got the Treasurer. I mean, it's gone up.
But he liked it.
The Treasurer said it's fantastic. Great numbers. We're on the right track. Roy, you know, based on that, I mean, Labor's track record when it comes to the economy has been quite bad and it is now reflecting in the polls. Do you think he'll go early or stick with it and try next year?
Well, Danica, I think there's no chance in hell that he's going to go to an early election. For a start, we've got in November the annual China-Australia Leaders Conference, and he's going to want to try to get some sort of diplomatic boost out of that, show that he can strut around on the world stage as a leader. Also, he's got a wedding coming up. Now, if you were his fiancée, would you want to have a wedding with a sitting prime minister or someone who is in the middle of an election campaign or possibly even out of office? Plus, he's also got to put as much distance as he possibly can between what happened with The Voice and the economic conditions. We've got 6 million people under mortgage stress at the moment with rates potentially going higher. So I think he's going to pull like a Joe Biden, try to run it out to the very end in the hope of a miracle and hope that, energy policy, we'll forget about these energy policy, we'll forget about cost of living, and we'll forget about inflation. And, so for those reasons, I think he'll run a full term. And if he could have another year, he'd take it right now because I don't fancy his chances at the end of this term.